But you shall receive power. You will speak and be unafraid.
You shall be my witnesses, and because of you, people everywhere will know my name. This is the power I give you through the Spirit.
Do not be silent, for all will hear you when you speak. Every tribe, tongue, and nation, all will see and know who I am. From the lips of the young to the ends of the earth, all know that I am.
It happened quickly. Disciples had gathered, as they always had since the rising of the sun. The same time, same place. It was about the third hour. The disciples were about to break bread, when suddenly, what sounded like a great army of beasts, or a thunderstorm, or even the earth turning over, it filled the room. They didn't know what to make of it, until they saw what some said were like swords, or spears, or cannons. But most said it was tongues of fire. It filled the room, consuming them, each and every one of them. They began to speak. They began to speak with tongues they had never heard before. The message, clearly understood by the different nations, was so easily received. Many saw and bore witness. Others were there to mock, said they were drunk. I tell you, they were filled all right, but not with wine. They were filled with the Spirit.
Last days, he will pour out his Spirit upon all people, all races, all tribes, all nations. Fathers, mothers, wives, husbands, sons, and daughters will prophesy. Young men will see visions, and old men will dream dreams. So the believers prayed, "Sovereign Lord, stretch out your hand to heal and perform miraculous signs and wonders through the name of your holy servant, Jesus." In those days, God says he will pour out his Spirit upon all his servants. They will prophesy. Day after day, in the temple courts and from house to house, they never stopped teaching and proclaiming the good news that Jesus is the Christ.
They spent time speaking boldly for the Lord, who confirmed the message of his grace by enabling them to do miraculous signs and wonders.
With shrieks, evil spirits came out of many, and many paralytics and cripples were healed, so there was great joy in the city. Men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, wonders, and signs, which God did among you through him, as you yourselves know.
And anyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.
One night, he had a vision. It was a man, a Macedonian, pleading, asking for our help. He called. We knew. We went.